Now that we've seen how Profile Editor handles alarms, let's dive into the databases and see what we've created. I've already added a new meter using the airport meter profile called DT2 Lite. In Studio, I'll navigate to the System Model tab and over to the Alarms at the top. If I click this drop-down menu, I can see all the different types of alarms available to me. Each alarm type functions in a different way. Some of these can be created automatically, some can be created manually, and some are not relevant to the drivers we'll be using. We'll focus on the most common ones for the moment. First, we have digital alarms. Conceptually, a digital alarm triggers on or off based on a digital tag. If I go down the fields here, many of these will be familiar from looking at the variable tags. Note that the alarm name is the description that shows up in the alarm views, while alarm description is the text used for each state. This is in order of alarm on text, comma, alarm off text. This was filled out as part of the variable tag, and we'll use the system defaults if left empty. What I want to show you is the source section. Here we have two variable tags. Normally, only one of these is filled in by Profile Editor, the variable tag that we want to trigger the alarm. We can also add a second tag to perform a logical AND between the two. That is, the alarm will only trigger when both tags are active. For example, if you're monitoring a generator, the limit alarms are only valid while the generator is running. There is one other piece of logic we can add here. If the alarm needs to be inverted from the variable tag, you can add the text NOT in front of the variable tag. If this is a normally closed breaker, I want to alarm on breaker open, not closed. In this instance, I would also change the alarm name and description to match. Of course, as I've discussed before, now that I've made manual changes to the database, I need to make a note elsewhere so I don't update the profiles with IO Device Manager and wipe out my modifications. The next alarm type I'd like to cover are analog alarms. These are the other alarms created by the PC-based checkbox in Profile Editor, and they have much more functionality available. The Profile Editor has filled out the basic values, like the name and variable tag driving the alarm. What it hasn't filled out are the limits below. The analog alarm has four limits available: high, high high, low, and low low. When the variable tag crosses each threshold, it triggers that specific alarm. This is also the text that shows up in the alarm view. Analog alarms do not have custom descriptions. Also, each limit has its own individual delay that can be configured. These fields need to be configured manually in the database. We'll see in a later video that these values can be added to our profiles, but not within Profile Editor. If these limit fields are not filled out, the analog alarm will never trigger. There are actually two other types of analog alarms that can be configured here if needed. While we focus on the limit alarms, the set point field can be configured with a fixed value or a variable tag. This works with the deviation field in that when the absolute value of the variable tag minus the set point is greater than the deviation, an alarm will trigger. We also have a rate of change alarm available. When the variable tag changes more than the rate over the past 60 seconds, the rate alarm activates. There are several parameters to control this, and I refer you to the built-in help for analog alarms. The last type of common alarm to look at are the timestamp digital alarms. We're going to ignore the other timestamped alarms because they don't function with our drivers. The digitals, however, serve as placeholders for the drivers to write alarm states and timestamps into. In fact, if you read these variable tags directly, they will show bad quality, as though they aren't even reading correctly. We can modify these the same as regular digital alarms, but otherwise, there's not much to see here. These are the most common alarms that you will encounter and possibly modify in the database. In the next video, if you're interested, we'll dig into two other alarm types that are less common. If not, I'll see you in the WebHMI. Until then, thank you.